So you're scrolling through Instagram and you see this awesome character animation someone claims they did in After Effects. And you're like, this is easy. I can do that. So you decide that today is the day you're finally gonna learn character rigging in After Effects. So you plop yourself down in your chair equipped with the essentials, an energy drink and a good podcast. And you vow that your butt will not leave this chair until you are done. A couple of hours later, you've designed a character that can only be described as your life's greatest work and a stroke of pure genius. Yeah, okay, buddy, keep practicing. After many hours of trial and error and having to repeatedly pause your podcast to watch a bunch of YouTube tutorials, you finally manage to import everything into After Effects and it's all rigged up and ready to go. You begin animating your first limb and... everything falls apart. So why does this happen? Well, let's look at a simplified limb. Here we have the upper and lower part of the limb. This applies to an arm or a leg as they both work on the same principle. The problem arises when the point of rotation for the elbow or knee is not perfectly centered on the joint. And so when the lower part of the limb begins to rotate, it breaks away from the upper part of the limb. The point of rotation oftentimes isn't centered on the joint because you try to eyeball where the center of the joint was. Okay, so now I'll show you some steps you can take so that you'll never have to guess where to put your anchor point. It all starts in the design process, so let's jump into Illustrator. Okay, I'm ready to create my limb. So I'm gonna grab the ellipse tool and I'm gonna create the top of my limb, and then I'm going to use the selection tool to create the elbow and the end by holding Alt and clicking and dragging. Okay, now I'm going to select all three of the circles, go to the align panel and make sure it's set to align to selection, which you can't see because it's off the screen. And then I'm gonna distribute the alignment so that my center circle is in the center of my two ends. Next, I'm going to select the center circle and I'm just going to hit Control Copy to copy to my clipboard. And then I'm going to grab the pen tool and I'm going to start on the top and draw a rectangle between the middle of the top circle and the middle of the middle circle. Now I'm going to grab all three shapes and group them together, hitting Control G or Command G. Now, if you remember, we copied that middle circle, so I'm going to hit Control Shift V or Command Shift V to paste that circle in place. And then I'm just gonna repeat what I did at the top of the limb, this time for the bottom part of the limb. Okay, so if you're not doing outlined artwork like I am in this video, then you can actually just skip to this part of the video. But if you are doing outlines, there's a few extra steps that you need to do. Okay, so now I'm going to start with the top of the upper limb. I'm gonna double click to open up that group, and I'm gonna grab the rectangle and the middle circle, and I'm using the shape builder tool, I'm going to combine them into one shape. Now I'm gonna grab the scissor tool and I'm gonna cut off the top of this new shape so that it's open. And then with that being done, the upper part of your limb should look like this. Now I'm gonna exit that group and I'm gonna go into the lower group. And I'm just gonna delete the center circle because I don't need it anymore. And then using the shape builder tool, I'm gonna combine these two shapes into one shape. And then using the scissor shape, I'm going to cut off the end of the lower limb. And once I've done that, it should look like this with an open path at the end of your shape. I'll exit that group. And now this is pretty much it. If you look, your limb should be working correctly. It's a little off because I'm just eyeballing the rotation point, but we won't be doing that inside of After Effects. So now your limb is pretty much ready to go. To create the sleeve of the shirt, I'll just copy this upper part of the limb and I'll scale it up a little bit and change it to the same color shirt, and then use a rectangle with the shape builder tool to cut the sleeve off. I'll hold Alt to cut that sleeve off, and then I'll combine the sleeve back into one shape. Next, I will grab the upper part of the limb and the sleeve and group those together.
Okay, so before you go into After Effects, if you want your limb to be tapered, I have one more trick for you.
Instead of creating three circles, you're gonna create two circles, the beginning and end. And then with both circles selected, go to Blend and switch the blend to specified steps and switch that to one. Hit OK, go back to Object, Blend, Make. and now you have this center circle. So now you can grab your end circle, and you can adjust the size, and it will automatically adjust the size of that middle circle to be even between the two ends of your limb. And now you need to just select the two ends and go to expand, hit OK, and boom, now you have three circles to work off of. And then now the process is exactly the same as before. Okay, so now for the easy part, I've got all my artwork in After Effects and I've converted everything to shape layers. If you don't know how to do that, just right click on your Illustrator layer and go to create on create shapes from vector layers. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to solo my arm just to make things easier to work with. And I'm going to start with the top of my arm because I'm going to be using DUIK to do my rigging. And with DUIK, we always work from the top down. So once I've created my bones, I'm going to grab the top joint. And while holding control, I'm going to drag it to the where I think the top circle is. And because we made that circle in Illustrator, you're going to see it. It's going to snap right to the center of that circle. So now we know that that joint is right in the center of the shoulder. And it's going to rotate properly. Okay, now I'm going to solo the forearm, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to grab that joint and hold control, and I'm going to make sure it's right at the top edge of that forearm and right in the middle of the arm. So it lines up there nicely. Next, I'm going to solo the hand, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to take this joint and make sure you only have one joint selected. And I'm going to do the same thing, holding control the whole time. It's going to center that right in the middle of the limb, that joint, and right on the top edge of the hand. And then once I'm pretty sure that that's in the center and lined up with my other joints, I'm going to take this tip and I'm going to just line it at the tip of my hand and make sure that it's aligned with all my other joints. So they're all in one straight line. Okay, great. That looks pretty good. I'm going to turn on my whole arm so I can see the whole thing. And now I'm going to parent the arm layers to the structural layers. And I like to name my arm layers the same as the structure layers just so I know what to parent to. Makes parenting really easy. And now that everything's parented to the right bone, I'll go to those structural layers and I will go to auto rig. And after a couple seconds, everything's rigged up. So now I'll turn off the visibility of my structural layers and it just has my controller. Now I can drag the controller and you can see that the limb now bends perfectly, seamlessly.
Okay, so I'm gonna wrap up and I just wanna quickly review what we did. We made those three circles. These three circles act as a guide for After Effects to know where we want to center our joints. So when we click those joints and we drag them over while holding control, After Effects will know that we want to center this joint right in the center of those circles. So those circles help After Effects, and then we build the rest of our limb with those rectangles that we drew out off of these three circles. So if you just follow these steps every time you create a limb for a character, and this works for the legs as well as the arms, then it will always work flawlessly. If you like this video and you found that it was helpful, hit that like button. If you want more videos like this, character design type tutorials, I recently did a poll and this was the highest ranked topic, so I'm gonna be doing more tutorials about this. Make sure you're subscribed, and if you do subscribe, make sure you hit that bell icon so you know when I'm uploading new videos. And with that being said, I think we'll see you guys in the next video.